We know that many of you have traveled from far and near and are looking forward to this evening's concert. We wish for everyone to have a memorable and pleasant experience tonight. With that being said, we ask that you would take a moment to silence your cell phones and other personal electronic devices at this time. Again, welcome, and we hope you enjoy the concert. At this time, I admonish you, we ask that you stand to your feet, and please welcome the distinguished director of choirs and associate professor of music here at Dillard University, Mr. S. Carver Davenport.
Would you join me in a word of prayer with all heads bowed? God of all creation, master of the universe, we thank you for this wonderful and joyous occasion. We thank you for 40 wonderful years of praise, 40 glorious years of worship, 40 masterous years of service. We thank you for Dr. Davenport and the many years that he has served faithfully at Dillard University. Bless this time that we spend together, and it is in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen.
Thank you. to the 2014 commemorative concert honoring Mr. S. Carver Davenport's 40 years of service here at Dillard University. This evening will be filled with music by current Dillard students and alumni from across the globe. We will begin tonight's performance reflecting the first 20 years of Davenport's career. A highlight from that period was the exchange concert series between the Morehouse College Glee Club and the Dillard University Concert Choir. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the concert.
Thank you. When I lay down, when I lay my head down to die, to die.
The second 20 years of Mr. Davenport's illustrious career includes the years 1995 to 2013. They brought more singers and more music, most notably the compositions and arrangements of Moses G. Hogan. This era captivated audiences with the now familiar selections such as We Shall Walk Through the Valley in Peace, Battle of Jericho, and I'm gonna sing till the spirit moves in my heart. This era also endured the heartache of what we all know as Hurricane Katrina.
Mr. Davenport and the concert choir survived a year of difficulty with holding choir rehearsals at the Hilton Riverside Hotel in downtown New Orleans. The choir has persevered and continued to carry a legacy of greatness all over the city of New Orleans and also all over the United States of America, the second 20 years of Mr. Davenport's illustrious career.
Yes. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We are the current Dillard University Concert Choir. And of course, we hail from right here at the gleaming white and spacious green Dillard University. Our president is the illustrious Dr. Walter M. Kimbrough, and our director is, of course, the incomparable, magnificent S. Carver Davenport. The first selection that we will sing for you tonight is Did It My Lord Deliver Daniel, arranged by Moses George Hope.
Deliver Daniel.
Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. As we now pause and take a moment to reflect on those fellow alumni that have passed on and transitioned into a life that is more abundantly in the bright heavens, in bright mansions above. Thank you. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. For in my Father's house, there are many mansions or many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you.
I go to prepare a place for you, for prepared people. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, all of God's children will be also. Lord, I want to live up yonder in bright mansions above. My mother is gone to glory. My father will be there too. But Lord, prepare a place for me in bright mansions above. Ladies and gentlemen, receive the Dillard University Concert Choir as they sing In Bright Mansions, arranged by Mr. Roland Carter.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, the next selection is Precious Lord, Take My Hand. And it was arranged by my mentor, Mr. Roland Carter, Roland Marvin Carter, a distinguished composer, conductor, pianist, educator, and he is the Ruth S. Holmberg Professor of American Music at the University of Tennessee in Chattanooga, which is also his hometown. His accomplishments as a leading figure in the choral arts are legendary, and he is specially noted as an authority on the performance and preservation of African American music. Dr. Carter is a graduate of Hampton Institute, which is now Hampton University, located in Hampton, Virginia. And he served as the director of the famed Hampton Institute Concert Choir, of which I am proud to have been a part of as an undergraduate student. Roland is unquestionably a gifted composer and arranger, and I'm very proud to have studied under his tutelage. He inspired and mentored me to also become a choral director. Reverend Dorsey said that he used Precious Lord, Take My Hand as an inspiration. Reverend Dorsey composed it. He used it as an inspiration in response to his inconsolable bereavement at the death of his wife, an infant child. Precious Lord, Take My Hand, a song that we all know, was inducted into the Christian Music Hall of Fame in 2007, and it also was included in the list of songs of the century by the National Endowment for the Arts. Ladies and gentlemen, Precious Lord, Take My Hand, soloist Reverend Cynthia Wilson.
Precious Lord, and lead me on.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand untied. I'm weak, I'm worn through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, and lead me on. Precious Lord, please lead. Please lead me on.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next selection is entitled Even So, Lord Jesus, Quickly Come, composed by Paul Mons. Even So, Lord Jesus, Quickly Come.
Please.
Ladies and gentlemen, shut the door.
Shut the door, keep out the devil. Shut the door, keep the devil in the night. Shut the door, keep out the devil. Light the candle, everything's all right. Light the candle, everything's all right. Oh, when I was a baby child.
Shut the door, keep out the devil.
Good and bad was just a game. Light a candle, everything's alright. So right.
Ladies and gentlemen, selection also arranged by Roland Marvin Carter, Lift Every Voice and Sing. Let us please stand for the singing of it, please. Organist, Mr. James Smith.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, For God So Loved the World, Reverend Cynthia Wilson, soloist.
Yes, He so loved the world. Yeah. city. And he said that everybody who believes on him, hallelujah, they shall not perish. They will not, they cannot perish, but
for the evening. He cares for you. Soloist Dr. Valerie Jones-Francis. Keith Tillman, drums, please.
Jesus Christ, I know he knows. in life, a goal I must attain, a dream that I must follow.
how can I say thanks for the things you've done for me, things so undeserved, yet you gave to prove your love for me. The voices of a million angels could not express all that I am and all that I ever hope to be. I owe it all to thee. To God be the glory. I'm so overwhelmed and happy. I would like for my family to stand up. My daughter April, attorney April Davenport, please stand. My wife Vicki. My niece Hope from Columbia, South Carolina, Hope Cobbs. And of course her father Mitch, my brother-in-law, all from Columbia, and my sister, Miss April Melody. My beloved choir members, former choir members, friends, students, colleagues, associates, my wife Vicki and daughter April, and Mr. Timothy Ray. I want to express my profound thanks and genuine appreciation for all you've done, for all of you who graciously thought enough of me to honor my services as choir director, of all of the wonderful Dillard University choirs over the period of 40 years. Although it was not necessary to honor me or to recognize me for my many years of loving service, I am sincerely appreciative of your efforts and the sincerity of your recognition. You have indeed humbled me by this wonderful event. I want you to know that I try to live in humble obedience to an inspirational purpose, to a divine calling, to a sacred mission, a ministry of transformation, using the gifts that God has given me to try and make a difference among all of the students that I have encountered over the years. I regard myself as a servant leader, one who served to bring joy, to bring peace, to bring love, heritage and change through music to all listeners and to the most in need of the confirmation of God's love. Whether it is the music of Johann Sebastian Bach, of Hall Johnson, of Richard Smallwood, of Roland Carter, Moses Hogan, and others, I have tried to broaden our understanding and acceptance of the variety of messages that the human voice is capable of conveying. My music career started at 5 years old when I sat by my mother on the piano bench, Clara Davenport, whom I miss so much, and whom some of you met when we were on tour in Columbia, South Carolina. It started as I sat on the same music bench and she played the piano in church. I knew then that this is what I wanted to do. My mother was a saint. My mother was a saint who loved the Lord. With all of her heart, with all of her mind, and with all of her soul, who initially saw my musical potential at such an early age, who loved and inspired me. and then placed me in the hands of the Lord. Music has been my mission. It's been my divine calling to bring healing, to bring understanding, and to bring inspiring messages that I hope would transform souls. As I listen to your melodious voices at rehearsal and at the performance tonight, it brought back so many wonderful memories that I have been so blessed to have. Memories that changed my life. Memories that drew me closer to God. Beautiful memories that could only be given by you because of your dedication to singing, your dedication to wanting to be the best choir member that you could be, and wanting to have the best sound that you could have. Beautiful memories from you that made Fair Dillard even more precious. I've wanted my 40 years to have been a ministry to young people, helping them to shape not only the musical talents, but their human development as well. Teaching them to care about themselves, to be professional, to develop their skills and talents, and to use them for an ultimate purpose. My 40 years have been filled with glorious moments and joyous expressions that will resonate within my being for the rest of my life. I will always remember the former choir members who are here tonight as young people coming to Dillard, wanting to be in the choir and wanting to learn how to really sing. I will remember how you who are professional singers now, how you polished your raw talents into a melodious professional instrument while simultaneously positioning your voices into the competitive field, and in doing so, deeply touching the lives of others. For all of that, I'm eternally grateful. In summary, I hope that I would be remembered as a choir director who loved developing young talent, who inspired the young lives, who modeled how to become an artist, to always be professional, and to be a good human being. I hope that I've left an imprint on the human family and made a difference in how we experience music, the art, culture, and life. So I want to thank all of you. I want to thank all of you for this distinguished honor, the recognition of my 40 years of directorship and service. Long after we've all been gone, long after we all are gone, it will be hopefully said that there was once a faculty member at Dillard University who told the musical story through his directing and his singing, who maintained the cultural traditions of our people, who exemplified excellence, exemplified heritage, and professionalism in all that he did, and who was able to do this for so many years because of his genuine love for teaching, directing, and performing. But through it all, who kept the Lord first in his life. I am proud to have been allowed to serve you over these 40 years, and may our Heavenly Father continue to bless all of you. And I want to conclude with a short prayer. Heavenly Father, Heavenly Father, as I recall the ways you've deepened my faith, there are faces that come to mind tonight. Good people you put in my path. good people who have remarkable faith stemming from a vibrant relationship with you. As you know, these good individuals here have shaped my understanding of your love and your faithfulness. Thank you for each one of these wonderful individuals that are here tonight, as well as the ones that wanted to be here. Thank you for your prayers, for their transparency, for their kindness, and also for their patience with me over all of these years. Thank you for Mr. Timothy Ray, who spearheaded this wonderful occasion, and for the other leaders who made it a reality. Through them and all of the wonderful former choir members and current choir members here tonight, I've seen what you are like and how blessed I am to have had all of them in my life. Because of this, Father, I give you all the glory and the honor. In Jesus' holy name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Please have a seat for a moment, just one moment. I guess I'll do this first. We have just a small presentation. Just a small presentation to give to you tonight. From all of us, all of the concert choir alumni members, 1975. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's said that we ought to get our flowers while we yet live. So tonight, in a very special way, we have a small token of appreciation for Mr. Davenport for all that he has deposited into our lives over the years. So at this time, if the committee members would come up really quick to join me in this presentation, we'd like to ask Mr. Davenport to come up for a small presentation. Once again, Mr. Davenport, thank you for all that you've done for us and for being who you are.
Hello, hi, good evening. We would also like to present Timothy Ray with a token of appreciation. He has been diligent in putting this whole thing together. We definitely helped, but this is his child, so here you go.
And one additional thing, for the sake of time, we do have several things that we'd like to present to Mr. Davenport. We have a proclamation from our mayor, Mitch Landrieu. We also have a proclamation from the Louisiana State Legislature, as well as a proclamation from Congressman Cedric Richmond. In addition, we have another proclamation from our general president of Alpha Phi Alpha, Brother Mark Tillman, who's a Dillard graduate, and also an initiative Beta Phi chapter here at Dillard. So on behalf of all of the Alphas who've come through Dillard via Beta Phi, Mr. Davenport, and all of the brothers, all the other brothers who are members of our fraternity, who are choir members, on behalf of Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated nationwide, we salute you tonight. Congratulations.
And lastly, in your programs tonight, you have this insert, the S. Carver Davenport Endowed Scholarship. And I'm going to circle back to it, hopefully. I'm reading this, it says, I'll start here. Riding here this evening, Olanna said to me, she got kind of emotional during rehearsal because she realized that she was just a choir member amongst 40 years of choir members. So for her, and for me, and for all of us, I'm sure, we think of it as what they define as a legacy. It says, anything handed down from the past. And if you look in your program, you see that Olivia Cooper was a graduate of 1982, and there are people here from the class of 75, and classes from the 1990s and 2000s, have all been a part of Mr. Davenport's legacy. The song Tyrone Johnson sang, Legacy of Love. That's what this is. And if you don't really understand it yet, I was looking on from the piano when the wonderful students from Landry Walker High School were seated here. They sang, they performed during the prelude, and Mr. Davenport taught Mr. Knox. Yes. And Mr. Knox taught his choir. And they sing some of the same songs that we sing, some of the same music. And I was watching their reactions to this great sound that we had up here. And I'm thinking to myself, I'm sure some of them will be at Dillard in a few years. And so if a legacy is anything that's handed down or passed on from the past, we need to make sure that we pass this legacy on to kids from Landry Walker so that when they're here for their 40th year, for their choir director, Mr. Davenport's another 40 years for him, we would have impacted them in the same way that he impacted us. We're asking for $40 contributions to establish a scholarship fund. And each dollar represents 1 year of Mr. Davenport's service. And so I hope to the students of Landry Walker and to any other young kids out there who may one day come to Dillard and sing in Mr. Davenport's choir, that when the class of 2014 wants to come back and do something here, that you would let them, you would welcome them, because we're all just one choir member amongst years and years of choir members. So please, help us establish and solidify this legacy. This will be a scholarship for music and choir students here at Dillard. And with your help, we can reach our goal and further the cause of Mr. Davenport's 40 years here. Thank you.
But before we do that, let us all stand and sing Fair Dillard. Words. Fair Dillard. Feeling that we will see each other again, but if we don't, we'll need each other on the other shore. Fare ye well. Fare ye well. Where you are, Dwayne? Oh, yeah. Dwayne. Oh, fare ye well. Fare ye well. I'll meet you on the other shore. Never, ever see you anymore.
Thank you.